unusual fellow. This guy must have captured the public in a way that I never thought could be done.
James Dean's death and its aftermath still haunt historians. Remember, Alec Guinness gave him a week to live. Did James Dean too somehow sense his impending death and his lasting fame?
My name is Carl King. Actually, my major form of income is street racing.
Probably about 3 months after I got my license, my first experience with street racing, you know, I was driving a long day, people saw I had like a pretty decent car, and this guy just asked me, hey, you want to race? I was like, race? You know, I was like, Tried it out, you know, I won. Second race, another guy, he called me out, he's like, you want to put some money on there? I was like, money? Oh, that's a new thing. And I tried it out, beat him, got some money, and then since then I've been betting for money.
Hey, you guys
want to
race?
Let's do it.
You want to race?
Yeah, let's do it.
How much money you got?
$1,000?
$1,000?
You
can do that.
I came here for school from California, so... Okay.
So about
4 years ago, probably about 18, 19 years old,
right.
You know, I just wasn't working out with my parents. I just, you know, I kind of wanted to go to school, so I just found out Savannah College was the best idea. So I came here with nothing in my pocket, started everything from scratch. So. Well, usually for street racers, if you love to race in general, you tend to drive a lot. Yeah. I drive almost every night. Drive around for the love to drive, you know, just to have that opportunity to shift gears and everything. And then luckily enough, you know, someone with a nice car revs it up, he either revs it up towards next to you or he flashes his lights behind you. That means, you know, you want to go. I'm like, all right.
It's closed up. Oh no, some people have been back here already. Luckily they opened the gate for us. Usually people with big ass trucks, they just pull on the chain.
One of those extreme sports, you know? Crazy people jump out of planes, you know, it is like a crazy life. So. Well, the time I got in an accident was my first car. It was a black hatchback. I was actually racing. And I couldn't get in my lane fast enough, and then the car ahead of me stepped on the brakes, and then it's gone. Yeah, the car was pretty much total. My front end basically went under the back of a pickup truck, and so basically my whole front was underneath it when we got in an accident. No one was hurt. You know, I got a couple of cuts and bruises, but other than that, you know, I've been fine. Luckily, the 5-0 didn't catch me or anything else, just an accident. They thought, you know, it's just like a freak accident, so I didn't get too much trouble for that. Just had to fix the pickup truck on my insurance. So yes, insurance is pretty high.
My name's Pete. I'm the mechanic.
This man does everything for me.
Yeah.
He works wonders.
We got the 1.8T here with the we got the turbo upgrade with the turbo's back here. It's a turbo upgrade from HKS.
Pretty much all done.
And we have also German made. We can't
new speed German made car, but
we're putting about
this one's all motor. About I worked all the 290 pitches of the wheels,
rods, everything.
It's pretty
this
quick.
Putting about 300,
yeah.
200 horsepower.
It's not bad. We're thinking of putting a limited slip in because we can't get no traction.
Cold air intake over here.
Other than that,
chip.
What's that?
Internals.
Not yet. That's the plan though.
Carbon fiber rims coming in. Okay.
You wanna show?
All that stuff's over my head. But,
sorry.
All right.
On average, I make about $200 to $300, and that $300 alone, you know, fills up my rent. And so, that one week, I paid a rent. You know, next week I pay electricity and whatnot. On average, the really experienced guys, you know, probably like been doing the same amount of time as me in this racing thing. I think they do, but usually people who have been putting up money are just kids using their parents' money, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And they just, you know, get it from them, and then guess who gets it? We do. Mm. like taking candy from a baby.
No, actually, the females are actually drawn to the street races. Like, the more you win, the more they're drawn to you. I don't know what it is. I guess it's like the whole rappers and groupies type thing. So it kind of works out the same way. But yeah. I mean, you really don't have to take them anywhere when you have this girl with you. I mean, all they want is a ride. That's all I'll give them. Well, two specific kind of rides. Mostly all these, I guess you call them groupies, they don't reject the lifestyle because they're there with us, you know, or all there talking and whatnot. Even racing sometimes, they're like, can I come? Sure, I don't care. I mean, but if it's like really something up for money, you know, you just like extra weight, so I say, hell no. But usually I know I can win, as you put it, you know, they can get it. So. Too Fast, Too Furious should be called Too Fast, Too Fake. No way all that stuff is happening. It's not really that organized because everything is really, you know, on instant. You know, you want to race, okay, so race, let's go here and race, put money up, do the race, get your money, go home. Or if you know if it's a good night, not that many cops out, you do a couple more. Nitrous, I don't mess with that, but that definitely does get you up there. But nitrous will have some bad effects on your car if you be using it too much, so I don't mess with that. Mine's just strictly raw engine power. You know, I stay with my turbos or superchargers.
Actually, my friend, he died in an accident that he was in, which kind of, you know, it's hard for me to take. I don't know, but yeah, he was racing too. He kind of went into a wall. It was one of those sharp turns. It's like a metal, not metal wall, but like he was on the highway when he got into the accident. It was a straightaway, then it comes to a turn. He tried to brake, but his car didn't brake fast enough. He ended up skidding, and you know, sidewall and car flip and smash. So yeah, he died on impact, so it wasn't too much pain for him.
Now I know it had to be hard on his family.
Yeah, like up to then his family didn't even know that he street raced. And then, you know, as soon as the accident came out, you know, it was in tabloids and, you know, police are trying to crack down on it, but we still continue to do it. From start to finish, what I experienced. First off, we were lined up. And usually the only thing I fear is, like, is this man next to me experienced, you know? Because I've been doing this for about 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 5 years now, 5 years under my belt. And this man, I don't know nothing about him. All I know, he's putting some money up, and I'm gonna get it. Usually off the start, you know, first thing is adrenaline rush, first gear. Second gear, I pull away, a little confidence. And once I pop in the third, it's like full strength, because I know I just beat him. And it's me all the way. Doing this street racing for a long, long time, and I remember that man, Jimmy Dean, or James Dean, not the sausage, but Jimmy Dean, he went out racing, and that's how I plan to go till I die. The